The following is a paid presentation for the Key of David, brought to you by the Philadelphia Church of God.
I am a voice crying out in the wilderness.
Good news for him and for you and for everybody, because we are going to have peace in Jerusalem.
The Key of David with Gerald Flurry.
Greetings, everyone. Did you know that when Russia attacked Georgia, that it was actually the beginning of the fulfilling of a great prophecy in your Bible? That is something we can prove to you very, very easily. And did you know that that great power of Russia is going to clash with a European superpower very soon? That is also prophesied in your Bible. And did you know that those two armies that clash are going to conclude, or at least they're moving to conclude that war in Armageddon or in Megiddo, which means Armageddon just means armed Megiddo, and it's going to be armed like never before. And that those very same armies in Europe and in Russia are going to clash in that great, great prophecy that people talk about so often. Did you also know that America and Germany had a lot to do with causing Russia to move into Georgia? I'll explain what I mean by that, but it's very important for you to understand President Bush is going around now trying to get Georgia and the Ukraine into NATO. But did you know his father promised Russia that they would never do that when he was president? That is, Mr. Bush's father was president. And did you know that Mr. Bill Clinton, when he was president, also promised that Russia, that we would never try to get Ukraine and Georgia and other nations around Russia into NATO? But we've broken those promises. And what does all of that mean? What is the meaning behind Russia's attack on Georgia? Let's first of all look at a scripture and show you what the Bible has to say about that. And we'll begin in Daniel 11 and verse 40. And at the time of the end shall the king of the south push at him, and the king of the north shall come against him like a whirlwind, with chariots and with horsemen, and with many ships, and he shall enter into the countries, and shall overflow and pass over. So here we have a clash between a European power and a radical Islamic power led by Iran. We've been teaching that for a long time now, many years. And these two powers are going to clash first. And then something is going to happen that has already manifested itself in Georgia. Notice verse 44. But tidings out of the east and out of the north shall trouble him. Therefore he shall go forth with great fury to destroy and utterly to make away many. But now that king of the north was victorious, that European army. But something very shortly after that begins to really bother them. Tidings out of the east and the north. We'll just call them the kings of the east, which is actually Russia and China. Revelation 9 verse 16 talks about a 200 million man army or 200 million soldiers. And that could only be Russia and China. Only they could field such a force against Europe. But here we see in verse 44 the official beginning of this great prophecy being fulfilled. Already that power is rising up, and this is the first military act of the kings of the East But it's not going to be the last, and there are going to be some that follow that are going to be shocking this world in a way it's never, ever been shocked before. Some of the media ask if this is a new era, and you can be absolutely certain that it is a new era. With Russia back in power, much like it was in the Cold War days, and they're going to be allied with China and perhaps even Japan, and it's going to be a mighty power. To give you just a little background on this and why Russia is so angry, let me just mention this, and we've got a booklet that will explain it very much in detail. But the Serbs ruled Yugoslavia until recently, when Germany, with American power, absolutely subdued that whole area. Now, Yugoslavia fought with us in World War I and World War II, and Germany fought against us in World War I and World War II. So did we betray the Serbs, our friends, in two world wars that Germany started? They started both of them. Is it possible we have made a serious mistake in the Balkans? Well, I'll tell you this, the United States didn't gain anything from that except a lot of wrath from Russia, because they had promised Russia they wouldn't do those things. But they did. At first, they were hostile to doing something like that, but Germany kept putting the pressure on, and we caved in, and Germany orchestrated the whole war, and it all ended in their favor. Is Germany our friend? Are they our friend? Do you think so? The Bible talks about our lovers, and God is upset about it. What does God have to say about that? Notice what was written in the Stratfor Intelligence. They mention here U.S. Presidents George H.W. Bush and Bill Clinton had promised the Russians that NATO would not expand into the former Soviet Union empire. The promise had already been broken by 1998 by NATO's expansion to Poland, Hungary, and the Czech Republic, and again in 2004 expansion, which absorbed not only the rest of the former Soviet satellites in what is now Central Europe, but also the three Baltic states, which had been components of the Soviet Union. The Russians had tolerated all that, but the discussion of including Ukraine in NATO represented a fundamental threat to Russia's national security. And then they began to get very, very angry. Now, he says here, the second and lesser event was the decision by Europe and the United States to back Kosovo's separation from Serbia. The Russians were friendly with Serbia, but we went right along with Germany, even though we were hostile to doing that in the beginning. Germany has been orchestrating all of this. Why? What is going on? Well, our booklet on the rising beast will tell you background here that will give you understanding of what's happening in Russia and Georgia right now, like you will find no place else. It really will. He concludes by saying, Stratfor report, the intelligence report, the Russians publicly and privately asked that Kosovo not be given formal independence, but instead continue in its formal autonomy, which was the same thing in practical terms. Russia's requests were ignored. They just ignored them. And we, through Germany's prodding, provided most of the power to do all that. And Kosovo was like one of the buffer states within the former Yugoslavian empire. But he concludes by saying, from the Ukrainian experience, the Russians became convinced that the United States was engaged in a plan of strategic encirclement and strangulation of Russia. From the Kosovo experience, they concluded that the United States and Europe were not prepared to consider Russian wishes, even in fairly minor affairs. That was the breaking point.